Good evening and welcome to this month's edition of Seasoned and Smart. This month, the subject is men's health. And we have as our guests, Arthur Funai and Steve Rogers. Earlier this month, we had a chance of visiting each of them in their respective homes, and they have demonstrated to us what keeps them active in their retirement. So let's roll the tape. Hi there, and welcome to the current edition of Seasoned and Smart. I'm Richard Hillman, and this week we're on the road to see what some of our friends are doing to keep active in their retirement. Our first stop is with Arthur Funai, who enjoys restoring antique cars. Hello, Arthur, welcome.
Hello, Richard.
Arthur, this is a beautiful car. Would you please tell us something about it?
Well, I got this car about 50 years ago, and it is a 1904 Grout steam car made in Orange, Massachusetts. I did all the restoration myself over the years, and I did everything except the upholstery, of course, and the tires I had to buy. Other than that, the car operates with steam. You have, in the front, you have a water tank with about 40 gallons of water. In the back, you have a gasoline supply, which burns in the burner under the boiler. You get steam up and you open the throttle and the car moves. And that's the way it works. I've had a lot of enjoyment working on this car over the years, and it's been my hobby since I was about 15 years old, old cars.
Well, then you certainly got a head start on it. You certainly didn't wait till you retired to get involved in this.
Yeah, well, it's been fun, a lot of fun.
Tell me, how fast will this go?
Oh, I'd say if you're going 30, you're moving.
30 is going very well.
The problem with steam cars, they say there's no limit to it, but there is. It's as fast as you can make steam, really. It's the amount of steam you can make gives you the amount of distance or speed that you can travel.
Well, is it the pressure of the...
That's right.
I see. So you can get in a single jaunt, how far can you go?
Well, you can go, it takes about a gallon of water per mile. And you might be able to go about 10 miles to 12 miles on a gallon of gasoline.
Oh, sounds not bad. Modern day cars don't do much better than that.
Well, this car hasn't got a computer in it. The computer's up here.
Mm-hmm. Hey, it's all that works. I mean, and I'm sure this was a loving project by the look of all of the work that's been done on it. And how neat and clean and polished it all is. I'm sure it keeps you busy.
Well, it certainly does.
So Arthur, the mechanism for all this is basically in the back of the car.
That's right.
Yes. And can you give us an idea of how that's functioning?
Well, it's basically a two-cylinder steam engine.
Okay.
Side by side, we can tip the seat back so you can look at it if you do so desire. Mm-hmm. And we can do that now. Just grab that handle and push it back. There's the fuel tank. There's the two-cylinder engine. It's a chain drive down to the differential. This is the oiling system. This little pony lubricator. Mm-hmm. There's the water pump. Over there's the muffler, and this is the accumulator, which builds up the pressure for the fuel. This is the line for the steam line that goes into the engine. And you put it all together, it's like a plumber's nightmare, but it works.
That's the name of the game. And if you're getting the kind of mileage you're getting with it, you're ahead of the game.
That's true.
Yeah. As far as the rest of it goes, You say the boiler is under the front, which is driving it back?
Yeah, the boiler's under
the
here.
Seat. Okay.
There it is. That's a 16-inch boiler with 350 fire tubes in it. The heat comes up through there and heats the water around the tubes. And
you said that's got, what, a 40-gallon capacity?
Oh, no. There's 40 gallons of water supply.
I see.
And that holds about a gallon and a half, 2 gallons.
So this flows into this,
yeah.
And this flows into that.
Yeah, it's the idea.
And it all works
but
together.
It's converted to steam before it goes to the engine. This is your throttle here. And when you hit the brake, it automatically shuts the throttle down. Over here is the control to keep the boiler level, water level up. Here's your level, your glass to see how much water you got in the boiler. And this controls the main fire, shuts it off. Other than that, it's all automatic.
Other than that?
Yeah.
Arthur, it's been fun. I really enjoyed it.
Well,
and I'm sure our audience will enjoy it too.
Thank you.
The second stop on our tour today is the home of Doc Rogers, who is going to take us on a magical mystery tour.
Hey, how you doing? Welcome. Good to see you here. I'm Doc Rogers, but some of you probably have heard of me as the Flim Flam Man. Now, I just want to point out, I do not do that anymore. Now, I'm retired. By choice. Wasn't my choice. Now, this judge thought I had to find another line of work, so I'm just taking it easy. Got a lot of time on my hands, and if you're interested in any of this, see me after the show. I also got myself one of these to help me take it easy.
That was easy.
Isn't it fun? Who are you, ma'am?
Rachel,
it is a pure pleasure to meet you. And you, sir, who might you be?
I'm Richard.
Richard, it is a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
Now, have you two ever been flim-flam before?
No.
How about the rest of you? You ever been flim-flam?
Yes.
And I'll bet you've been flim-flam several times, yes. Madam. Yes, okay. Well, you know, I used to flim-flam, but I don't do that anymore. No. I'm going to show you how I did it, though. I used to use a deck of playing cards that are mostly different. And the power of my mind. Now, here's what we're going to do. Rachel, I'm going to ask you to say stop. I'm going to show you a card. You remember it. And then I'm going to read your mind. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Stop.
Take a look at that card. Remember it. And remember Doc Rogers, the Flim Flam Man. All right, Rachel, now concentrate on your card, okay? You saw the Ten of Diamonds, is that correct?
Yes.
That was kind of meager there. I think I'm going to do this again just to make sure you've all seen it. Could you say stop, please, ma'am?
Stop.
Right here. Take a look at that card. Remember it. Remember Doc Rogers, the Flim Flam Man. Concentrate on your card. It's the King of Hearts, is that right?
Yes, it is.
Wait a minute. I know what. You guys think. You guys are thinking that I have been looking at these cards. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No, I don't look at the cards because, you see, it wouldn't do me any good. Because these cards, they're blank on both sides. So looking at them wouldn't help a bit. Well, now you can say you've been flim-flammed by Doc Rogers, the Flim Flam Man. Thank you. Wow, you're going to struggle for that. Listen, how many of you guys out there, sir, do you have a $500 bill?
No.
I knew I picked the wrong guy. How about the 100?
No, can't.
50? Surely somebody of your means must have a 20.
I might be able to squeeze that out.
Could we see it?
Sure.
Excellent. Very nice. It's got all the right stuff here. Jackson, everything. Now, you know, Richard, I don't actually need 20 bucks. I only need about 18. So I'm going to give you a little receipt and a rebate. There's two bucks. I'll keep the other 18. All right. So, Richard, I need for you to do one more thing for me here. And that is, would you please write your name right across that bill there in nice big letters?
Mm-hmm.
You know it is illegal to write your name on money like that, don't you?
Well.
That's why I have you do it. Actually, Richard, that's not true. I have you write your name on that bill so you'll be able to recognize it should you ever see it again.
Aye.
Now, you know, the reason I asked for a 20 is there has been a real problem lately with fake $20 bills here in Lynn. Hmm. And I'm gonna show you just how you can detect one of those. The first way you can tell is they kind of feel funny. Do you feel that? Yeah, this one might be. Second way is they kind of smell funny. I think it's the ink.
Mm.
But the third way you can tell for sure is if you warm it up and the ink changes color, that is for sure a fake bill. Let me see here.
Whoops.
That was a bad one, Richard. Have you got another 20?
I'm afraid I haven't got that much of one.
Don't worry. Listen, I know it's not much, but push the button, you'll feel better. Okay.
Easy.
And don't you worry either, Rachel. We're going to find his bill. And when we do, you just have to promise to really applaud. Will you do that?
Okay,
because these guys on Tuesday afternoons are half asleep. And... All right. So, anyway, I see that it is time to be running along. Mullen's running out of tape and everything, so we got to get out of here. And I just hope you had a good time. We're going away. Oh, wait a minute. I feel awful bad, Richard, about not giving you back your $10 bill. So I am going to offer you one of mine. I happen to have some 20s here. I don't know where I get them all. But we'll give you one of those. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, I'm sorry. Mine are counterfeit, too. Yeah, well, I don't know what to do here. I know what. The only thing I can do is just, you know, point out again that if you push that button, you probably feel a lot better. There. Oh, wait a minute. There's something wrong with that. Well, there's a bill in there, Richard. And it's a 20. You don't suppose. Let's check that out. You got your receipt? Wow. Looky there, Rachel, huh? Fits pretty good, doesn't it?
It does fit.
And, Richard, is that your signature?
Yeah, it looks
it's
like
your
it.
Signature? Rachel, this is his bill, and you said you'd applaud. And you say, oh, okay, yeah, okay. Wow, she's doing it. That's great. Oh, good. How about a big hand for Richard and Rachel? Here, Rachel, get something nice for yourself. Well, friends, I hope you had a good time. I hope you know who you were had by. It was Doc Rogers. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
That was a lot of fun, Doc. Thank you very much for the entertainment.
Glad you enjoyed it.
And now we'll be talking further soon. If you can whisk us away to the studio.
I'll see what I can do.
Well, that was something. Arthur and Steve, I thank you very much for a wonderful, entertaining time at your homes. Now let's get to some nitty-gritty. Steve, tell me a little bit about your background.
Well, from my work life, from my vocation, I was a molecular biologist. I have a degree from Johns Hopkins and worked for Monsanto. And I retired in 2002. And that was about 2 years after I rediscovered magic. I had done it when I was a child and then stopped when I was about 18 or so when I went away to college. And so it gave me a chance to fill the time and learn a lot of new things.
Well, that fits right in with the theme of men in motion. I mean, molecular biology and magic. I mean, this all comes together. And Arthur, you've been at your car restoration for many, many years.
When I was 15 years old, I was interested in old cars. But in my work, I worked for General Electric for 45 years. Mm-hmm. And I was a manufacturing engineer. It was a very interesting job, solving problems, putting products into production, etc. And I retired about 26 years ago. So anyhow, I got all this time I was interested in old cars. And my first car was a Model T Ford 1916 Roadster, which I restored. My next car was a 1949 Jeepster. And then I got a hold of the Steamer, which is a 1904 steam car, and I've been working on them ever since. I love it.
Well, it certainly shows by the way you've restored that vehicle. I mean, it could have been off the showroom floor. There isn't anything in there that isn't polished to the nth degree, and it just looks wonderful.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, I'd love to take a ride in it sometime.
Okay.
Steve, let's go back to you for a moment. You say you rediscovered your magic. That means you started earlier, I assume.
Yeah, when I was, I think, 7 or 8, I would get books out of the library as I was growing up. My family would give me magic kits, etc. And so by the time I was in probably 8th grade, I was doing shows for Cub Scouts and churches and groups like that. And I did continue to do some magic in the early days that I was in college, but then just kind of got involved in the other things, you know, finishing the degree, getting a job, all those things. And I really, while I was interested, I really didn't get seriously involved again until about 2000.
And you've gone on beyond that to do other things as well to keep you active.
Oh, yes. Well, in terms of the magic itself, I've had 30 years I had to learn that I didn't know about. Plus, there are groups and clubs here in the area. I have been involved in those different clubs. One of them is here in Salem. And that's kept me busy. They're contests, so I've worked up acts for the contest. Matter of fact, part of what I did on the video was my act for a contest a few years ago here in Clinton, Massachusetts.
Which I understand you were very successful in.
Yeah, I won. It was such a shock that they have no longer held that contest. I am the reigning and current champion because they're afraid to have it again, I think.
You mean you were so overwhelming that nobody can even see themselves achieving that?
There were other reasons.
And Arthur, you've got other things in the works besides just your own personal cars that you're doing.
Well, I put on old car shows, and we try to educate people on cars. At the end of this month, we're going to put on a show at the Senior Center in Lynnfield, and we'll have about at least 30 or 40 cars. And there probably will be at least four steam cars that I know of, which is very unusual.
Yes.
And that's part of the thing. The game is people and education, and on and on it goes. There's no end to it. It's a small world.
It sounds like a great family day out there.
Excellent. It's the 29th of June at 10 o'clock at the Senior Center in Lynnfield. And you can have a cheap day because it's 50 cents for each item that you want. And you can't beat that at today's prices.
You mean I can get your steam car for 50 cents?
That's not for sale.
But you also are involved in putting on shows, Steve.
Yeah, one of the organizations that I belong to is the Society of American Magicians. Assembly 104, that's in Salem. And we have a one-day convention and then a public show every November. And this year will be November 5th, and we're holding it at the Marriott in Peabody. And if you are interested in it, I think they'll give the give more detail, including the website where you can find the information at later in the show or at the end of the show.
Very good. We'll look forward to it. And all in all, aside from your magic and your car restoration, there've got to be other things that are keeping you occupied.
Well, you can't imagine how it keeps your mind active and solving problems, and it's just wonderful. It keeps you going.
That's the key to it all.
It's wonderful.
Do you have clubs also for the...
I belong to about four clubs, yeah. Steam Automobile Club of America, the Launcher, American Launcher Club, the Veteran Motor Car Club of America, and that's enough.
That sounds like it keeps you going.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And Steve, aside from your magic, you're involved in a lot of other things as well.
Yeah, one of the things I got interested in a few years ago was genealogy. And my family, my father was from Kansas. I am from central Illinois. And so imagine my surprise to find out that my family lived in Lynn from 1651 to about 1780. And then moved to Maine and then to the Midwest. So it's been a lot of fun, and I had no idea there was a connection, and discovered that through doing the research. And that, you know, that's something that anybody can get interested in now. Much of it is on the internet. You can get started there, and that's how I started.
Well, it sounds like neither of you are lost for things to do.
No, I bought a laptop about 6 months ago. At my age, coming up on 92, but it's a wonderful tool. You can find out anything you want in there.
Well, you're a better man than I, because I haven't been able to find what I look for. But hey, it's the nature of the beast. You got to put the time in, and you got to concentrate, and you've got to learn. And that's what it's all about. And I hope all of our listeners will take advantage of both of your shows coming up, and we'll talk certainly about it in the future. And as yours is upon us at the end of June, come November, maybe we can get a plug in for you on your...
That'd be great.
Yeah. And it's a matter of getting everybody else who's watching here to follow in your footsteps, to find things that will keep them motivated and active and functioning. Do you have any advice for people as to the direction they might want to be looking at?
Well, I've had that question asked me a lot of times. And I can't give an answer. I've done nothing special, but I've always been interested in new things. And I was lucky enough that my supervisor always gave me the latest technology that I'd go into. And I always loved that. And I still do.
Yeah, that's one of the fascinating things about magic, although it's been around since, there are supposedly pictures on the walls of some of the Egyptian tombs of people doing magic. There's always something new, there's always something to learn, and because it's not only the magic tricks themselves, but it's also the history, the collecting. There are people who don't do any magic, but they have more than I will ever see in my life, because they are collecting it because of just the history, the ingenuity. I mean, it's a pretty fascinating and broad subject.
Yeah. Has technology played a part in magic?
Oh, yes. There's a kid now who does an act with lasers, and he bends the laser beams. I mean, it's amazing. So they're just fantastic things that people are always thinking to do.
And it goes on and on and on.
And it will.
Good. We certainly hope so. And, you know, at your stage, you're an example for all of us to keep on cranking, as it were. Well, no pun intended.
But, you know, in the last 30 years, things have moved so fast. I'm a little jealous that I can't be a little longer so I can see some of the incredible things that are coming up.
Well, I'm sure that you will be, and I hope all our viewers will be as well, because we'd certainly like to see you back here again next month, and we look forward to your getting active and staying in motion and getting things done. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you next time.